Hello and welcome to our Binance series. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be teaching you how to trade on Binance for beginners in Nigeria. In this Binance series, we have covered a lot of tutorial. First of all, we saw how to open a Binance account and how to verify it. Then I did a tutorial on understanding the Binance interface. I also did a tutorial on how to trade P2P on Binance in Nigeria. That is how to buy and sell on the P2P platform using your Naira in Nigeria. So in today's tutorial now, I'm going to be teaching you how to make money on Binance, how to trade on Binance and make lots of money. So first of all, we have done the P2P trading, which we use to deposit money into our Binance P2P wallet, which is the only option you have in Nigeria to deposit money into your Binance wallet. So we have done the P2P and we have bought some USDT. So now we'll go to our wallet and go to our P2P wallet to transfer that money from our P2P wallet to our spot wallet, because that is the platform we are going to be using to trade. Okay, so let me talk about the spot trading a little. So on Binance, we have three types of markets. If you come to the market down there, we have the spot market, the futures market, and the zones market. The spot market is where we are going to be trading today. The spot market is called spot because you can trade on the spot. Unlike the futures market, where you predict the future price of an asset, in the futures market, if your predictions are not correct, you can lose all your money instantly. But the spot market doesn't work like that. In the spot market, you come and buy a crypto asset, and as the asset increases, your money increases. However, when the value decreases, your money also decreases, but we know that the price of cryptocurrency will always come up whenever it goes down. So you won't lose all your money instantly, just like the futures market. So we are going to be trading in the spot market today. So after trading in the P2P platform and you have deposited money into your P2P wallet, you now want to transfer that money to the spot market so you can use it to trade on the spot market. So from my P2P wallet here, I'll just click on transfer to transfer the funds I have in my P2P wallet to my spot wallet. So I click on transfer and you can see transfer from P2P wallet to spot wallet, and I'll choose the currency I want to transfer. So I bought USDT, so I've searched for USDT, so just come search for USDT. I have some funds in my USDT, so I want to transfer the maximum amount. So I have 100 USDT, so I'll just transfer it from my P2P wallet to my spot wallet. So I'll click on transfer. Successfully transferred. So the money has been transferred from my spot, from my P2P wallet to my spot wallet. I've refreshed it now, and you can see that I don't have any money in my P2P wallet. So when I go to my spot wallet now, okay, so I had some money there before I made the transfer. So you can see that I have 232 USDT on my spot wallet. So now I can now trade in the spot market. So I'll go to market and I'll look at the currency I want to trade. So these are my favorite cryptocurrencies. As you can see, it's clicked favorites there. So you can search any cryptocurrency you want to, any cryptocurrency pair you want to trade on the search button here. So you can just search for say Dutch. Okay, Dutch USDT, Dutch BS, BUSD, Dutch Euro. So what I have is USDT, so I can just click on Dutch USDT. So this is how Dutch has been doing against USDT. So the number one secret, and like the only secret of trading and making money on Binance, is to buy the cryptocurrency when it is cheap and sell it when it has gone up, when it is expensive. So that is the number one secret traders use. Just like every other business, you buy it when it is cheap and sell it when it has, when the price has gone up, when it is more expensive. So that is like the main secret to trade and make money with cryptocurrencies. So because the cryptocurrencies are volatile and the prices are always going up and going down, going up and going down, like you can see in the chart here. So what you want to do is to view the chart, look at the market trend, and determine the lowest price it usually comes to and buy it at the lowest price you can buy it. Then from the chart also, you can see the highest price it comes to. Then you determine to sell it at that highest price. So that is the secret you need to trade and make money on Binance. So you come down, you look like, okay, at this point now, the lowest price that it has been is, the lowest price that Doge has been is 0.277, 0.277, 0.29, 0.277, 0.29, 0.28. So we can see that, okay, the support line down here, 0.25, is always at 0.2. So you want to buy it at the lowest 0.2 price that the market has, that the market usually comes to. Then you want to come and sell it at the highest point, which is usually 0.35, 0.33, 0.3 something. So for this market now, for this Dutch market against USDT, what you want to do is wait for it to drop to about 0.2 something. Then you come and sell it at 0.3 something. So that's how you make money and you increase the value of your crypto assets. So if you want to do this, so let's say we want to trade Doge now, want to buy Doge on Binance. So we'll come to the trades. You can see trades at the bottom of the screen, the middle. So we can see trade at the bottom of the screen, the middle, at the middle it is written trade. So we'll click on trades. So we'll come and trade, okay, same BNB USDT there. We'll come and we can change this by clicking this BNB and USDT. You can change the cryptocurrency pair you want to trade. So let's say we want to trade Doge. So we want to buy Doge now. We want to buy it cheap and sell it high. So we'll click on Doge. And from the market we saw there, we saw that the highest point is always at 0.3 something. So it's at 0.3 something now. So I don't want to buy because it is high. Let's click on that candle and we'll see. So it's actually high now. So this is not a good time to buy. You want to buy it when it has dropped down to 0.2 something. So you buy it at 0.2 something, and when it increases back to 0.3 something, then you want to sell. So that's how you make market. So that's how you make money on Binance. That's how you trade. So this chart now, there are different charts you can use to determine the market. So this is the candlestick. On my screen at the left corner, you can see where it is written line. If I click on that, the chart will change. So this is the line graph. You can also use it to determine the volatility of the market, the market trend. You can use it to determine the market trend. If I click on, so there are also other things you can use to determine the market trend. If you can see this thing at the middle of my screen at the right, that is written, that I will just click on it after depth. This thing that is here in front of depth, when I click on it, you see other things you can use to determine the market. So you can see indicators, you can see height, you can see drawing, you can see more. These are more things you can use to determine the market trend. So you know the best place to enter into the market and where to leave. So I don't like using the lines. I like using the candlestick. You can also expand this thing by clicking this expand button by the right here. I'll just click on it and the chart is going to expand. So you can see the chart on full screen right now. So as you can see, you can use the line chart to determine the market, or you can also use the time intervals. This is the 15 minute time interval of Doge against USDT. Every candlestick here represents 15 minutes. This is the 1 hour time interval. Every candlestick here represents 1 hour, what happened in every hour. This is the 4 hour time interval, which tells you what happened in four. Each candlestick here represents 4 hours, so each candlestick here tells you what has happened in the last 4 hours. And we also have the day, we also have the 1 day interval. So every candlestick here represents 1 day and tells you what has happened in each day. So to read the candlestick, as you can see, the candlesticks have there's a line above, there's a thin line above, and there's a thin line below. So as you can see, there are red and green candlesticks. The red candlestick represents a bearish market, and a bearish market simply means the price is going down. When the price is falling, we call it a bearish market. So that is what the red candlestick represents. and the green candlestick represents a bullish market, which is when the price is going up. So that is what the green candlestick represents. And you can see the thin lines above and below. Some have only below, some have only above, but we can see some are longer above, some are longer below from the trading chart, as you can see here. So let's look at one, for example. Let's look at this third to the last one at the right here. So we can see this candlestick that I just clicked on. Now when I click and hold it, this information about the candlestick comes up. So the candlestick is green, and as you can see, it has a thin line above it and below it. Those lines represent something, they mean something. So let me use this red one to explain, because we can see that this red one has the thin line above is longer than the thin line below. When the thin line above is longer than the thin line below, that is that market is about to start falling, it's about to start going down. So as you can see, the next candlestick after that was going down, it's going down. If we come back to something, let's look for one that the candlestick below is longer than the one above. So let's look for one that the candlestick has a line below it longer than the one above. So with this thick one here right now, this one that I have clicked right now, we can see that on this red candlestick, the thin line below it is longer than the one above it. So when the thin line below is longer than the one above, that is that market is about to start going up. And as we can see, the candlesticks after it started to go up. Whenever you see the thin line above longer than the one below, that means the market is about to start going down. So that is how you understand the market, know when to come in and when to go out. And like I said, the secret is to buy low and sell high. Buy it when it's cheap and sell it when it's high. And you can use this trading view here to determine where to enter the market and where to leave. You can determine the best place to enter and the best place to leave. And you can use these time intervals, the 4 hour, the 1 hour, the 15 minutes. There is more here. We have 1 month. Yes, this is the 1 month chart. This is what Dutch has been doing in the last. Each candlestick here represents 1 month. We can see other. This is 30 minutes. So every candlestick here represents 30 minutes. So you can use these time intervals to determine when to enter the market, to read the market, so you know when to enter and when to leave. So I'll just go back. So I'll just go back and show you an example of how to buy and sell Dutch. So let's say I want to trade on Dutch against USDT. So I'll click on Dutch USDT here, and I already have some USDT, so I can come and click on buy. I have some USDT in my account. You can see the amount I have available. So we can see the current price of Dutch changing right here, 0.31809, whatever is changing right now. So if I want to trade Dutch, I'll come and buy. So I'll come and buy Dutch. I don't have any Dutch right now in my wallet. If I click sell and try to sell maximum, say I have so my available Dutch here is 0.0811. I can't use that to trade. So I'll come and buy Dutch. So the secret is buy low and sell it high. So we can see the current price of Dutch. Now if I try to enter the market, I'll look for a price that is lower than the current market price. So okay, it has come back to 70. Let me buy it at 60. So I have determined I want to buy my Dutch at 0.31760, lower than the current market price. So what amount of Dutch do I want, and the total USDT? So I'm going to invest 20 USDT. Once I put 20 here, you will see the amount of Dutch I'll get. So once I invest 20 USDT, they will give me 62.9 Dutch. So the price I want to buy it is 0.31760, lower than the market price. So I'll just click on buy Dutch. So my trade has been opened, and I want to buy Dutch at 3.0. I want to buy Dutch at 0.31760. So if the market drops to this, my price, I'll get 62.9 Dutch. So let's hope the market drops to my price. Okay, it almost got there now, but it went back up. But yeah, surely it's going to come down to that price. Let's see. I hope it doesn't waste our time. The market doesn't want to drop again. Okay, it's dropping now. So definitely drop back to our price. So okay, it doesn't want to drop to 60. So definitely drop to 60. The market is very volatile. Okay, so it has bought. You can see it has disappeared. It has gone to 0.31751, which is lower than the 60 which we wanted to buy. So we have successfully bought Dutch now. So I can now sell that Dutch I have bought. We bought it at 0.31760. I can determine to sell it at a very high price. So I have bought it at a low price now, and I want to sell. So I can see when Dutch comes to 0.9000, I want to sell the Dutch I have. So this is the available Dutch I have, 62.9811 Dutch, which I bought at about $20. Yes, I bought it at $20. So if I can determine that I want to sell it when Dutch rises to 0.900, I want to sell all my Dutch. So imagine when happen now, when I determine to sell my Dutch 100%, the Dutch I bought for $20, if Dutch rises to 0.9, I'm going to get $56.61 for that. So I have made over $30 from that. So I'm going to make in over $30 from that trade. So that's how you buy low and sell it when it's high. So my Dutch I bought for $20, if I sell it when Dutch gets to 0.90, I'm going to get $56. So I will just click on sell, and the trade is going to be opened. So you can see the trade has been opened. So whenever Dutch rises up to 0.9, Binance will collect my Dutch and give me 56 USDT. So that is how you buy low and sell high. So it's going to take a while before Dutch gets to 0.9, so I'll just cancel that trade and sell it at a higher price than what we bought it. So the Dutch I just bought, I want to sell it and get my money back, because I just did that for the tutorial. So I'll decide to sell it when it gets to 0.31. Okay, let me sell it for, so I'll sell it for 0.31800. So when Dutch rises to this price, I want to sell all my USDT, and I'm going to get 20.00220. So that's again I'm going to be making for that. So I'll just click on sell. So when Dutch rises to this price right here, my Dutch is going to sell automatically. So I don't even need to watch the market. I'll just leave it and it's going to sell. So that's how you buy low and sell high. So remember the different type of trades, the limits, the markets, and the stop limits. So in the limits market, I was only able to set one price, but in the stop limits market, you can set different prices. You can set the stop price, the limit price. So that is how you trade Dutch. That is how you buy and sell Dutch or other cryptocurrency, not just Dutch. That is how you trade cryptocurrency on Binance and make money. You can decide to do the same thing for Bitcoin. So in this tutorial, we learned how to trade on Binance, and we said the secret is to buy it when it's low at a cheap price and sell it when it's high at a higher price. Just like every other business, you buy cheap and you sell it high to make a profit. And we also learned how to read the market, so we know when to enter and when to leave. And we saw the different time intervals, 15 minutes, 1 hour, 4 hours, 1 day, 1 month. We can use that to determine when to enter and where to leave. So with this trend now, you can know that, okay, the price of Bitcoin is actually high now. It's not a good time to enter. So you can wait for it. It's definitely going to fall back because the market is volatile. When it falls back to like $43,000, you can buy, and you can now set it to sell when it rises up to $47,000. that is for USDT against, that is for Bitcoin against USDT. So that is the simple secret of trading on Binance and making some money on Binance using the trade, using the spot market, using the spot market to trade. So you can also trade using the you can also trade using the futures market, but the futures market is very risky. You can make a lot of money fast, but you can lose your money very fast, unlike the spot market, where even when the price goes down, you can just wait. When the price comes up, you make your money back. But in the futures market, once the price goes against you, all your money is gone. So when you're trading on the futures market, you have to be really careful. Even Binance will warn you about that. So you need to really learn the futures market before you trade there. But the spot market is quite simple, and you can use it to make money on a daily basis. You just come click a cryptocurrency you want to trade, to click a cryptocurrency you want to trade, buy it at a low price and wait for it to rise up and sell it at a high price. Whenever it goes down, you are good, your money will definitely rise back. And whenever it goes up, you can determine to sell or leave it for a long time, and your cryptocurrency and the value of your cryptocurrency will be increasing. So if this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe for more Binance tutorials. Leave your questions in the comment section below, and I will do well to answer them. I'll see you in the next tutorial. Cheers.